present of the meeting, Professor K.M. Kadar Mohideen, President Indian Union Municipal League, respected Congress President Dagurji, respected leaders assembled here, along with all of you, I also pay my respect and homage to the loving memory of my dearest friend and colleague. Our relations goes back to our days in the youth movement. When I was in the youth congress, he was leader of the Muslim Youth League. That time onwards, we became friends. Till the last days, we stayed together. I don't want to mention all these personal things. His loss is really a personal loss to me. Luckily, now, in future, I don't have to visit foreign countries. But if at all it happened at that time, I would have been in a difficult position. In all my travels abroad as defense minister, all my close foreign laws were given by my elder brother, Amasai. That kind of intimacy was between us. Dagurji correctly said that Amaji is an institution. That's it, enough. My thought is going one or two recent incidents. Mr. Sam Charney is here. I'm thinking aloud. If Amaji was in the External Affairs Ministry, nobody in the Government of India would have thought of taking a decision of having two types of passports. That decision hurting the self-respect of lakhs and lakhs of Indians. Luckily, the government has averted that. At the moment, India's relation with the Middle East has improved a lot. We have got a relation with almost all the Middle Eastern countries. More than anybody else, Amasai's contribution in strengthening the relation between the Gulf countries, Middle Eastern countries and India is, we cannot forget that. For the Malayalis living in Kerala, living in other parts of India, in Delhi and Middle East, he was a real friend in need. Malayalis living in Delhi, even midnight, they can knock at his doors for any urgent help. That was the person of Yahoo. Rajaji was telling, Ahmad represented India abroad. He gave a correct image of India abroad. Is correct. Many years as a minister of external affairs and also as MP. he was able to project the shining part of Indian secularism. But I have my doubt if Ahmadi is with us now, even he will fail to project that part correctly now, unless the present rulers of the country correct their mistake. In every respect, Ahmadi's contribution to the country, the secular forces, and Malayalis is immemorable. I once again pay my respect to his memory. I'm sure people of Kerala especially will remember his memory long years to come. Thank you very much.